Assalamualaikum dear students, I'm Miss Aisha Baloch with the second part of my video lecture on tenses. In today's lecture, we are going to have a recap of sentence constructions of the different aspects of the present tense, and by the end of this video, you will learn the Urdu identifications of each of the aspects of the present tense, which will be helpful in translating an Urdu sentence into English. Let's begin with the first aspect of the present tense, which is present indefinite tense. In my previous video, we had learned that an affirmative sentence in this aspect takes a subject in the beginning, a verb in its first form, and other parts of speech. So, for the identification of this aspect or any tense in an Urdu sentence, we focus on the last part or ending words in a sentence. For instance, if a sentence ends at these Urdu words that you can see on your screen, we can say that the sentence is of present indefinite tense. For example, मैं अपना काम वक्त पर मुकम्मल करता हूँ. As you can see here, the sentence ends at ता हूँ. Similarly, if a sentence ends at ता है और ता हूँ for masculine, ती है और ती हूँ for feminine, or ते हैं for plural subjects, we know that the sentence is of the present indefinite tense in an affirmative form. Likewise, if an Urdu sentence ends at these identifiers and it also has a word of negation, नहीं in it, we know that it is a sentence of the present indefinite tense in the negative form. For example, मैं अपना काम वक्त पर मुकम्मल नहीं करता हूँ. I do not complete my work on time. Previously, we also learned the sentence constructions for interrogative or intronegative forms. But sometimes, in an interrogative or intronegative sentence, it also has a WH or H word, such as what, why, how, etc. So we have them in the beginning, then a helping verb, a subject, the word of negation not for the intronegative form, then the verb in its first form and other parts of speech, and also a question mark at the end. For the Urdu identifications, we have kya, kyun or kab in it apart from the identifiers that we learned just now. For example, क्या तुम अपना काम वक्त पर मुकम्मल करते हो? Do you complete your work on time? Example number 2, वो अखबार कब पढ़ता है? When does he read newspaper? Last one, तुम उनको जवाब क्यों नहीं देते हो? Why do you not reply them? For the second aspect, the present continuous tense, we know that in the affirmative form, we have a subject in the beginning, a helping verb is or am or are. Verb in its fourth form, the progressive form, which is always used in continuous or the present continuous aspect of the tenses, and then the other parts of speech. So, the Urdu identification will be raha hai or raha hu for singular masculine subject, rahi hai or rahi hu for singular feminine subject, and rahe hai for plural subjects. For example, bahir barish ho rahi hai. It is raining outside. Let me notify you one thing here, that if in a sentence a subject is not known or not mentioned, we use the pronoun it or they in place of a subject in a sentence. Similarly, the negative form of this aspect in an Urdu sentence will have the same identifiers and the word of negation nahi in it. For example, Hamza ye kitab nahi pad raha hai. Hamza is not reading this book. For interrogative or intronegative form of the present continuous tense, as discussed earlier, it will have the identifiers of the given aspect and will also include the question words kya, kyun, kab, etc. in it. For example, क्या हम नया घर खरीद रहे हैं? आर वी बाइंग अ न्यू हाउस? एग्जाम्पल नंबर टू, ये मशीन काम क्यों नहीं कर रही है? Why is this machine not working? Example number 3, वो कैसे पढ़ रहा है? How is he reading? As we know that the third aspect of the present tense, which is the present perfect tense, is usually used to show activities completed in the immediate past, and its sentence formation has a subject, a helping verb, has or have, the past participle of the verb and the other parts of speech. So, the Urdu sentence identification of this aspect will be alif, hai or hu for the singular masculine subject, choti ye, hai or hu for the feminine subject in the singular form, and badi ye, hai for the plural subject. For example, उसने दरवाज़ा बंद कर दिया है. He has shut the door. For the sentence identification in the negative form, we have the same identifiers as mentioned for the affirmative form, but here we will have the Urdu word of negation, नहीं. For example, मैंने अभी चाय नहीं पी है. I have not taken tea yet. Likewise, in the interrogative or intronegative sentence in Urdu uses the same identifiers as the previously mentioned two forms plus the question words that you can see on your screen. For example, kya tumhari ammi ne khana tayar kar liya hai? Has your mother prepared food? Second, unhone hamara intezar kyun nahi kiya hai? Why have they not waited for us? The third example, Akbar ne ye ghar kab kharida hai? When has Akbar bought this house? Now let's talk about the last aspect of the present tense, the present perfect continuous tense. We have already learned about this aspect in detail in my previous video. So now let's learn about the Urdu identifications of this aspect. As you can see here, the Urdu identifications are same as the continuous tense, but here we have an addition of either the beginning time or complete duration of an action. For example, वो दो घंटे से कुछ लिख रही है. She has been writing something for 2 hours. For the negative sentence, we have an addition of the word of negation, नहीं, before a verb in the Urdu sentence formation. For example, वो दो घंटे से कुछ नहीं लिख रही है. She has not been writing anything for 2 hours. Oh, and by the way, before proceeding on, I would like to highlight the difference between the use of the words something and anything that you can see here in the examples. Actually, we use the word something and in a positive statement or an affirmative sentence, as we generally call it. And we use the word anything in the negative, an interrogative or an intronegative form of the sentence. Likewise, in the interrogative or intronegative sentence in Urdu, we will, apart from the identifications, raha, rahi, etc., also have the question words like kya, kyun, etc. And in case of intronegative, the Urdu word of negation, nahi. For example, वो सुबह से ये किताब क्यों पढ़ रही है? Why has she been reading this book since morning? क्या तुम उसे 5 घंटे से तलाश कर रहे हो? Have you been looking for him for 5 hours? क्या वो जनवरी से यहाँ नहीं रह रहा है? Has he not been living here since January? So dear students, in this lecture, we had a recap of the sentence structures in the 4 basic kinds of sentences of all the 4 aspects of the present tense. Besides this, we have also learnt about the present tense and its aspects identifications in the Urdu sentences. I hope you have understood all the details well. And now is the time to assess your knowledge. So, as you can see on your screen, this is your home assignment. You have to translate the given sentences from Urdu to English. You have to complete this assignment in your registers. Thanks for watching this video lesson. Have a great day.